Hello everyone and welcome. Recently, I've been playing Minecraft quite a lot, and like so many adrenaline and danger-seeking individuals, the hardcore difficulty was and maybe still is what makes me come back to Minecraft over and over again.
Get the fuck out of my room and play Minecraft!
Again. Is this a bad thing? I don't know, but what I know is that disappointment that you feel when you make progress on your beloved hardcore world, only to die a few days later because of a small mistake.
No!
Or because you weren't confident enough in your abilities and still decided to take that certain risk. Today, I wanna tell you a few reasons that may potentially be the cause of the stress and frustration you feel over losing hours upon hours, to the point that some may actually quit the hardcore difficulty or Minecraft in general. Because, let's be honest, no one likes to put time in something only to see it go to waste. So without further ado, let us begin with number 1. You let others tell you what your goals should be, or you just copy their goals. Okay, this may sound a bit confusing, so let me explain. If you make right now a search on YouTube, "I survived X amount of days on hardcore," you will notice that a lot of these YouTubers who post their journey have a certain thing in common. They want to beat Minecraft, as if this game has a certain end. They hurry up to beat every single boss in such a way that it makes it appear cool. Not judging, maybe it is cool, but the cool thing is actually the editing. If I make right now a journey of myself, surviving 100 days on hardcore without editing, just pure gameplay, nobody will actually watch that because I didn't make it entertaining enough. They also make it seem like you have to follow certain steps to play the game. For some, these videos may actually be inspiring, but be careful. Just because someone did something and they had fun doesn't mean you will have fun. Maybe they played a lot more Minecraft than you did, and they know what they are doing. Don't hurry up into playing your worlds the same as they do. You are not them. Set your own goals. Also, this brings me to number 2. Set goals you actually are 100% confident you will achieve. So, you may think, okay, if I don't play like these YouTubers, then what should I do? Minecraft is boring without the things you tell us to stay away from. Okay, you think Minecraft is boring without going to the Nether, beating the dragon, warden, wither, raiding, I don't know how to pronounce that, then I invite you to think of the times where the Minecraft did not have such stuff, where the game itself was about finding your own goals, not letting a certain YouTuber or maybe the game itself tell you what to do, where you had to be creative. You see, I believe Minecraft Hardcore is amazing, and you know why? Because the things you do might be gone tomorrow, or even now if you play. You don't know when a creeper is gonna explode behind you. You don't know when you're gonna fall into lava, so I suggest you to set your own goals. Minecraft itself is not specific. You make it seem like it has specificity. You give meaning to it. Grab a freaking paper and write down what you are gonna do the next time you play. Heck, even building a dirt tower is fine. And when you finish it, you might actually feel something. What are you waiting for? Set some goals and achieve them. Also, if you want to specifically play Minecraft for beating the bosses or the way these YouTubers do it, good luck and I hope you are ready to suffer a little, cause it's gonna be hard. Remember, hard but not impossible. Speaking about suffering, this brings me to the next point. Yes, disappointment. Remember the pain you feel over losing progress and the time you had wasted? Well, I'm here to tell you something. This is actually quite beneficial. Why? Because that initial pain is gonna be your reminder of being careful the next time you play it. The pain is the greatest teacher in life, and Minecraft is no exception to that rule. I know, it can be hard and you may feel like smashing your keyboard. But if you try over and over again, this emotion is gonna be your best friend towards having the best Minecraft hardcore world you ever had. I hope you find these tips helpful and maybe inspiring. Just so you know, I'm no expert in Minecraft. I just survived a little more than I actually expected myself to. And I did it while following what I mentioned above. Subscribe if you want, and like, and I'll maybe see you in the next video. Goodbye.